my God. When I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hand has made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, the power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
We continue our Holy Week worship in the second of 3 days, Good Friday. We recall the early stages of Christ's passion yesterday, his gathering with his disciples in the upper room for Last Supper, his washing of the disciples' feet, and his call to a new covenant, to love our neighbor as ourself. In this second day of the 3 days we call Triduum, we remember Jesus' passion and death. This service of prayers, readings, and song is quiet, simple, allowing us to reflect on Christ's passion, his humanity, his love. Almighty God, look with loving mercy on your people, for whom our Lord Jesus was willing to be betrayed, to be given over to the hands of sinners, and to suffer death on the cross, who now lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Isaiah 52. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up, and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance, and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him, and for that which had not been told them, they shall see, and that which they had not heard, they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity, and as one from whom others hide their faces. He was despised, and we held him of no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole. And by his bruises we are healed. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We've all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth, like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent. So he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice, he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence, and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offering and shall prolong his days. Through him the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out himself to death and was numbered with the transgressors. Yet he bore the sins of many and made intercession for the transgressors.
We hear God's word. We offer up our hearts during this time of reflection. We also offer our resources. On the screen are ways in which you can give to our ministry electronically. Thank you for supporting our ministry. Because of your generosity, we're able to include you in our observance of Holy Week, our prayers of Good Friday. Thank you for your generosity. Lately, I've attended and officiated a good number of memorial services. And I've been struck by the stories, the affirming words that family and loved ones have. And maybe the word to best describe is the legacy the deceased loved one leaves behind generates those affirming words and a legacy. Jesus' legacy is historic. Now, the people I helped memorialize in recent weeks, some of them will have stories about them and memories of them echoing for generations to come. Jesus' legacy was historic. It changes values of peoples and nations. Jesus' legacy, his story, his good news of truth winning over lies, of grace winning over evil. That legacy echoes throughout the centuries. His stories, the memories and witnesses of his legacy come to you and I this week. For that matter, every week. Today's service is our opportunity to reflect on that legacy and to see how that legacy has been the fulfillment of ancient prophecies, ancient poetic texts in the Jewish tradition. May these words of Scripture and these prayers open our hearts to the life-changing legacy, to the supernatural story of God's promises coming to fulfillment in Christ. On Good Friday, we hear portions of Scripture that recall the Passion of our Lord. These portions of Scripture include the seven last words of Christ. When they came to the place that is called the skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said,
"Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing."
And they cast lots to divide his clothing, and the people stood by watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself. If he's the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, reading, "This is the King of the Jews."
One of the criminals who was hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and save us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied,
"Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." Standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother,
"Woman, here is your son."
Then he said to the disciple,
"Here is your mother."
And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home.
I so lost, I should.
When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which means,
my God, why have you forsaken me?" That all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture,
"I am thirsty."
A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth.
Upon the cross of Jesus,
Jesus had received the wine, he said,
"It is finished."
Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
"I give you across your shadow for my abiding place. I ask no other sunshine than the sunshine of his face.
Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said,
"Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
Having said this, he breathed his last.
What wondrous love is this, O my soul, O my soul.
Oh,
Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the whole church throughout the world. Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all the nations in Jesus Christ. Help it to persevere in faith, proclaim your name, and bring the holy good news of salvation in Christ to all people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for our bishops, for our pastors, and all people who serve the church. Almighty and eternal God, your Spirit guides the church and makes it holy. Strengthen and uphold our bishops, pastors, and other ministers and lay leaders. Keep them in health and safety for the good of the church, and help each of us in our various vocations to do faithfully the work to which you have called us. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray for those preparing for baptism. Almighty and eternal God, you continue to bless the church. Increase the faith and understanding of those preparing for baptism. Give them new birth as your children, and keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for our sisters and brothers who share our faith in Jesus Christ. Almighty and eternal God, you give your church unity. Look with favor on all who follow Jesus, your Son. Make all the baptized one in the fullness of faith, and keep us united in the fellowship of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for the people of Jewish faith, the first to hear the word of God. Almighty and eternal God, long ago you gave your promise to Abraham and to the teachings of Moses. Hear our prayers that the people you called and elected as your own may receive the fulfillment of the covenant's promises. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for those who do not share our faith in Jesus Christ. Almighty and eternal God, gather into your embrace all those who call out to you under different names. Bring an end to interreligious strife, and make us more faithful witnesses of the love made known to us in your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for those who do not believe in God. Almighty and eternal God, you created humanity so that all may long to know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may recognize the signs of your love and grace in the world and in the lives of Christians, and gladly acknowledge you as the one true God. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for God's creation. Almighty and eternal God, you are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold all the worlds in the arms of your care and bring all things to fulfillment in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for those who serve in public office. Almighty and eternal God, you are the champion of the poor and oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority so that all people may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and a share in the goodness of your creation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray for those in need. Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and new courage to those who have lost heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free those unjustly deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their time of need. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Behold the life-giving cross on which hung the salvation of the whole world. We glory in your cross, O Lord, and we praise your holy resurrection. For by your cross, joy has come into the world.
God be merciful and bless us. May the light of God's face shine upon us. Let your way be known upon the earth. Your saving health among all nations.
We glory in your cross, O Lord, and we praise your holy resurrection. For by your cross, joy has come into the world. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. May God give us blessing, and may all the ends of the earth stand in awe. We glory in your cross, O Lord, and we praise your holy resurrection. For by your cross, joy has come into the world.
We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.